Hello and welcome to Mobility Conversations. Today we have a special guest who is leading the engineering and innovation at India's largest car maker, Maruti Suzuki India. He has headed various product development teams. Mr. C.V. Raman, Senior Executive Director, Engineering. Raman Sam, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much, Dipanchu-san, for having me here today. Thank you.
So, sir, first of all, I would like to understand, we have seen a steady rise in vehicle prices in the last couple of years, primarily due to rising of input costs as well as addition of new features and technologies. Can you please share a perspective on this?
Well, I think if you see the Indian auto industry, it has been growing. And initial years, it was growing on the basis of the entry-level cars. And if you see up to 2011-12, even up to 2013, the growth was happening in the entry-level cars. But thereafter, I think it was about the customer's aspiration level changing, the income levels changing, and also newer kind of vehicles coming in. So then there was this shift towards the premium hatch and the sub 4 meter sedan. That's where the growth then shifted. And today, if you see, the growth has now shifted to the SUV, compact SUV and the mid SUV segment. I think there has been a change and it has been based on the way the customer is changing. But having said that, I think the important point here to note is that this entry-level customer still remains. That's number one. And number two, the entry-level volume has, as a percentage, has kind of remained at a similar steady level, 9%, 10%, give or take 1 or 2%, But I think overall, that's what I remember, that the entry level has more or less held its ground. And that's because, there is this need of the first-time buyer who's looking for an entry-level segment. He wants to move from maybe a no vehicle to a four-wheeler or a two-wheeler to a four-wheeler. And of course, there's a lot of other things which are there, which is happening in the mobility, in the way the customer is graduating. But let's talk only about entry level, and this is what is happening. Despite the regulations becoming stringent from, BS3 becoming BS4, then becoming BS6, a lot of safety regulations coming in. And all of that, the entry level has kind of held its own. There has been changes in the products which have been launched. And so I think, yes, there is still, we believe, in the entry level segment.
Okay. So, as you mentioned about the input side increasing and the overall price hike of cars, but cars like Alto and Espresso hasn't seen that substantial rise. So how did you manage the cost in this segment?
Well, I think if you see the pricing over the last 10 years or 12 years, Alto LXi is one of the largest selling models or variants of Alto. And if I remember correctly, somewhere in 2007, I think the price of the Alto LXi was about 2.68 lakhs.
Right.
And currently, if you look at it, it is roughly around 3.68 or 3.7 lakhs. So there has been a price movement as far as the Alto LXi is concerned, which is the largest selling variant, and has increased by almost 1 lakh rupees. And the input side costs have also, if you take off GST, in the similar level of input side costs have increased. But having said that, I think the important thing is that all the cost has not been actually passed on. The cost increase has been much higher. And as you rightly asked, that there are a lot of changes which have happened in the vehicle engineering for trying to reduce the cost. And Maruti Suzuki has always been very quite aggressive about doing localization. And so localization was one large component of as the volumes increased and the scale increased, we were able to do more localization at the R level, which is at the tire at the OEM level. Second was at the tier one level, a lot of inner parts were being imported. Over a period of time, all those inner parts were also localized.
Okay.
And so therefore, we were able to, you know, kind of beat the cost curve.
Okay.
And thirdly, I think a lot of value engineering, value analysis was done, a lot of benchmarking and seeing how we can re-engineer parts.
Right.
And all of these efforts have kind of resulted in what is what you see today.
Okay.
There has been an increase if you look at just purely from a 12-13 year horizon. There has been an increase, by, and one could say it's substantial. But if you look at inflation, you know, if
right.
from that perspective,
right.
I think it has been quite in control.
Yeah,
from
and
that
if we compare to
and we're still able to create. Yeah, sorry.
Sorry,
we're still able to create a value product for the customer at the entry level. By you know also giving features, we are also increasing the making sure that it meets all the regulatory requirements and current regulations. So I think a lot of effort has been done all around by our suppliers, by our engineering teams, by our production engineering teams, in order to reach where we are today.
You rightly mentioned about the localization of different parts that you know have been able to beat the cost curve. If you talk about materials, you know, can you give us an insight on the materials used and what sort of changes have you brought in the last few years to ensure better safety, increased efficiency, and performance?
Well, examples would be more on optimization of the materials, the localization of some of the electronic parts. Looking at alternate sources of suppliers to reduce that, to reduce the overall cost. Looking at material substitution, metal to plastic was one of the things which has been looked at and has been incorporated. Lightweighting, using of tensile steel, high tensile steel. There are various things which have happened in various aggregates. You know, it's not just one or two things which has happened, which is a big ticket. It's all around a cost reduction. Every element, every part has been looked at to see how we can, you know, reduce the cost. And that's how we have gone about it, going through the entire bill of material, checking each of the parts, weight and price, benchmarking that and seeing how we can, you know, further reduce that cost, including import content and of that particular part, and also trying to do some benchmarking. So it's been not just one type of part, but a whole lot of.
So talking about the consumers' demand in specific, you know, SUVs continues to grow, and at the same time, small cars are somewhat losing its sheen. But Maruti Suzuki has tried to address the demand with products like Brezza and S-Cross. Can we see more SUVs from Maruti Suzuki in this year or maybe next year?
Well, I think we've always been working towards whatever is the need of the market. And from that perspective, yes, hatch segment, entry hatch is held its in a way its own. But yes, from a percentage point of view, the growth you don't see. The growth you were seeing in the past was on the premium hatch and on the under 4 meter sedan segment. And that's where the growth is. And so today, if you see, there is not much of a growth. It is holding its own as far as the percentage is concerned. All the volume is getting shifted and percentage is going to the SUV segment. And it is taking the some percentages from each of these segments to increase its overall volume share. And so I think we will definitely be looking at these SUV segment space, and whatever is the growth which is happening, we'll definitely participate in that growth going forward.
Okay. And what is your take on where India stands right now on the electric vehicles?
Well, a lot of impetus has been given towards the EV electric vehicles in terms of giving incentives, demand side incentives on the GST benefit which is there, and we've still not seen traction whether it is the two wheeler or the four wheeler. Two wheeler is still better, but four wheeler definitely we're not seeing those volumes. So what is it that is, you know, is inhibiting the growth of this, you know, is something which one needs to understand. I think primarily it will be, you know, it will be the, first of all, the acquisition price. The acquisition price is much higher than a normal ICE vehicle. So if you compare ICE vehicle versus its equivalent electric vehicle, it may be almost double the price. So that's one. Second is that the battery capacity, which is directly proportional to the range of the vehicle. I think that is something which is key, which, you know, customer looks for, that how many times he needs to charge, you know, that vehicle. And if and there is a range anxiety which is built into in the customer psyche, so which one would not like to live with. The third thing would be the infrastructure for charging. I think India has not, we have not been able to build that infrastructure of charging the way it has happened in China or in some of the, you know, European cities where you see a lot of penetration of electric vehicles. And it needs a lot of effort which is required in order to do that, you know, the charging infrastructure. It's a huge task. And fourthly, I think the way we have structured our urban cities and our houses, it is not very conducive today for, you know, charging. Even if you, you know, people are today, I have seen many houses, they don't have charging points down. And they stay on the first floor, they'll have to drop a cable to do that. Otherwise, you need to make a point. And study shows that about 60% of our vehicles are parked on the road. So how do you do this? I think these are things which need to be you know, addressed. But having said that, I think the electrification is something which is very, very important for India. I think we need to look at it. And Maruti Suzuki has gone about it in a totally different way, is what I will say. And I think if I can say this, that we have started with, you know, if you see our vehicles, the lineup which we have got, we have the mild hybrid technology, which we have already introduced. We have the start-stop technology, which has now come into our engines. This definitely helps in, you know, reducing the fuel consumption. Ultimately, what is the purpose of building, of getting an EV? The EV we are trying to get, if we can reduce the, you know, overall CO2 and reduction. And if I may say, we are able to reduce CO2 or fuel efficiency improvement by using technologies like start-stop and mild hybrid technology. And going forward, Suzuki Global is working with Toyota. And we are in, you know, and Suzuki Global is working on how to bring hybrid technology, strong hybrid technology into India. So I think this is the steps which we are looking at. And recently, Suzuki Global has also announced its next term plans, long-term plans. And in that, building EV is also a very important thing. But so I think we need to have this progression of technology. Each segment has needs a different kind of intervention, because when we are talking about, and we started our discussion with the Alto, and we are talking about, you know, how cost is important for the entry level customer.
Right.
So you can understand that, you know, this is the key point, that, you know, how to keep the price point correctly there so that the customer can buy. I think that's very, very important. And if you know, if today battery prices, if you see the average price of a vehicle, ICE vehicle, is about 650,000 rupees. And the battery pack itself for a 200, 300 kilos may cost around the same. So I don't know. I mean, this is just a guess, you know, but looking at various vehicles and what I have seen, I don't have clear knowledge of this, you know, from a cost perspective. But from the pack perspective, this is what is happening. So I think this cost has to come down, and it'll come down if we are able to aggregate demand, if we are able to look at holistically the electrification, how we can bring down the cost of the motors, the cost of the power electronics, cost of the batteries and the cells which are there. Localization is going to be key. And so over the next 5 to 10 years, I think this is something which we need to all work as India to you know, reduce the cost and going forward, bring electrification in various forms. Each segment will require a different strategy, is what I believe.
But you know, Maruti Suzuki has already done a very rigorous testing on its EV prototype. And so are these the only reasons that that's holding back Maruti Suzuki to launch?
Yeah, I mean, we need to make it a you know, viable proposition to the customer. And so ultimately, we need to you know, look at how in what segment we should bring in the electric vehicle. And the absorption capacity of each segment is different.
Right.
So if you look at a premium luxury vehicle, it's 40-50 lakh rupees, 60 lakh rupees. You know, you put in a cost of 10-20 lakh rupees, it doesn't make, you know, it will make a difference, but it is, you know, the percentages wise is very different.
Right.
You're talking about a 6.5 lakh rupee vehicle or a 8 lakh rupee or a 10 lakh rupee vehicle. Then the absorption capacities for this technology is something which is needs to be also looked at. And it has to be looked at in conjunction with overall the range which you are able to give and the charging infrastructure. And all of this has to work together in tandem. You know, all the vectors need to be aligned, and we need to find solutions for all of this. And if you are able to do that, because ultimately the charging infrastructure also requires capital, is capital intensive.
Right.
And it has to have its own return. And, you know, the electricity by itself may be cheaper. Okay, than petrol, and the running cost may be cheaper, but to set up that infrastructure is going to be important. So the best way is, can we charge it at home? And that's the solution which we need to look at. And can we enable all homes to become, you know, where they can, where electric vehicles can be charged in the condominiums and in all the other places? Can we build that kind of an infrastructure? Right. Is important.
So the Indian industry has been seeing steady increase of connectivity features in vehicles across the spectrum. How do you see the increase, not just for your products, but the industry in general?
I think connectivity is something which we are, you know, really today, and we are today connected, you know, in a way. We are on the digital platform.
Right.
You know, many years ago, we would have done it on a physical face-to-face kind of a meeting. So connectivity has become very important. Digital platforms have become very, very important. And that's the way in which it is moving. And having said that, I think the vehicle itself as a mobility solution, the connectivity is becoming very, very important. So the way in which we are doing the business is, you know, is digital. And we are connected on the go all the way, all the time. We are connected at home, and we are connected in the, we want to get connected in the vehicle. I think that is what we need to, you know, go forward. I think that's what is going to happen, where connectivity is going to become very important, because the customer, once he gets into the car, he wants to have the same kind of experience, whatever he is having at home, in terms of streaming of music, or in terms of having any kind of a voice-based command, or any of those aids which he is having, which is, you know, which he's getting so used to and at home. And expecting that is, you know, is just for the customer, it is very, you know, simple. Yes, why it's not there in the car? Car should also be connected.
Right.
And today, the mobile is the medium through which it is happening. Mm-hmm. And so how the mobile and the car and the infrastructure can connect is definitely the way forward, I believe.
Sir, next year by April 2022, you know, CAFE norms would be implemented. So, is Maruti Suzuki ready with its engineering to
We are working double time, Tibanjasan, but you know, current lockdown situations, last year we have lost a lot of time.
Right.
We have, because of the social distancing, we have not been able to have full capacity at our R&D centers. Now also with the second wave, it's become even more worse. And right. So definitely it is very, very challenging for us to meet these you know, CAFE and other norms which are coming in 2022 and 23. And definitely industry has requested that you know, some breather on this. However, we are still not had any you know, anything positive on that, but we would definitely hope for that. But having said that, we still need to work on whatever we have to work in terms of our product development. We are doing our best effort. But I think, you know, in the current circumstances, is a really tough situation.
Okay. Sir, one last question. You know, there is a lot of speculation around Jimmy. So if you can share some thoughts on this, when it is really planned, or we can just hope.
Yeah, Jimmy. Jimny is a special product, and it's a product which you know, people actually are looking forward to, and we have shown this in the Auto Expo and last year. It was very, very you know, well received, and a lot of people were looking at it. But I think it's a different kind of vehicle. It is not it's a leisure. It's a different genre of vehicle, and so and it's a three-door vehicle. That's the other thing. So it's a very, very niche volume is what we believe. There will be enthusiasts like you who would always look for it, but these numbers are far and few is what we believe. So we'll study it, we'll see how we can look at it.
Okay.
But no plan.
Thank you so much, sir, for giving your time today.
Thank you.